All right, welcome back inside our Proactive Newsroom. And joining me now is John Dwyer. He is the CEO of Gamelancer Media Corp, at least for now. And I'll explain in a second. John, good to see you.
Great to see you. Thanks for having me on.
Yeah, so you're here today to talk about a rebrand. You're going to be moving to Vertiqal Studios, so from Gamelancer. Just off the top, John, why the name change?
The marketplace continues to see Vertiqal Studios, formerly Wonder Gaming, or Wonder Media rather, as an opportunity to source both creative video assets and distribution on TikTok, Instagram, and Snapchat. So we are a business that monetizes through producing content. We have our own production studio in-house, now called Vertiqal Studios, and we can produce everything from a feature-length film to 15-second TikTok, Instagram, Snap, both organic content and paid. And then in addition to that, we own this massive network, and that network is 66 channels, 44 million people, 69% of those people live in the United States. Now they're watching our gaming channels. In this a network of 66 channels, there is Gamelancer, and Gamelancer constitutes the largest network of gaming channels on TikTok, the largest community of gaming-focused channels and people on TikTok, and that's really important. So to pay that the attention that it deserves, but to also communicate to the market more broadly that we are more than just gaming, we rebranded as Vertiqal Studios. Vertiqal is unique because everything that exists on TikTok, Instagram Reels, and Snap Discover is going to be 16:9 vertical video. So all the video that we shoot and all the video that we distribute is technically vertical. So Vertiqal Studios made a lot of sense.
Yeah, it also really sets the company up for this transition into the United States as well, because it gives you a fresh look. New eyes will be on the company as well. So is that another reason why? Is that New York and US focus?
This is what we're hearing in the market. You know, we're very fortunate to be provided guidance from our advisory board, which include, you know, some of the biggest minds and names in media over the past 20 years. And so, you know, being in market with some of our advisors and talking to the big holding companies, you know, we had live on our network last week, feature movies that are coming out with some of the largest movie studios in LA. It hasn't been announced, but if you go onto our channels, you can see all of the new business that we're driving. You can see us driving one of the most popular mobile games that's about to launch, one of the most popular cartoons of the last 10 years running on our network right now. You know, these media companies are very particular about what they let you press release and things of that nature. But the great thing about Gamelancer is you can get in and see us working with all of these massive US brands right now. You can go and see it on our channels. And so for us, this adaptation and this re-architecting our narrative is about where demand lies. So, you know, every company has to iterate. You want to talk about Bell? They started off as a telephone company. Look what Bell offers now. What does Bell have to reconcile? The fact that we have max 35 years of television left, right? This is a new paradigm. So as we move into the United States, we've got to create an opportunity for the media world to be able to buy Gamelancer and diagnose us really quickly as a video production and a distribution asset. And so all of this endeavor really helps accomplish that.
Okay. You also made some changes on the corporate side as well. A couple of your co-founders staying on the board, but transitioning into different roles. And that's sort of just to shore up as you make that transition, John?
Yeah, we've done a very diligent job of really looking around the table looking at reducing costs, but also, you know, just aligning on where priorities reside. Raz Romanescu and Darren Lopez founded Gamelancer. They are part of the lifeblood of not only our company, but this industry, because they also founded 10 p.m. curfew. Gamelancer announced a partnership, now Vertiqal Studios, of course, announced a partnership earlier this summer with 10 p.m. curfew. They own At Girls, At Style, At Makeup. Go onto TikTok and look up these channels. They're huge. What we're building is the next ABC, CBS, NBC Studios. That's what these companies are. So we need to create a sense of sovereignty at the management level, because Raz and Darren are also simultaneously building 10 p.m. curfew. So what we did is we resolved to have them become board members, which they have been now since June. And so we've got Darren and Raz entrenched, you know, big shareholders in our business, directors of the company, which is important, but they're also operating 10 p.m. curfew, and we're working together in the market. So to have them in management on both would make it tricky in the long run. So it was really just to tidy it up, but also to align these two great businesses to continue to grow together. We're in the early days. Again, everybody needs to start thinking of assets like Vertiqal Studios and 10 p.m. curfew. Look at the assets that are in the marketplace that are buying up these channels, that are building studios. We're building the next television network. It's only existing digital. So the moment the retail and institutional buyers out there start to figure that out, I think we're going to get a lot more support.
All right, we'll leave it there. We should mention also, as Vertiqal Studios, you will be trading, you already are, as a matter of fact, on the Toronto Stock Exchange under the symbol VRTS. So we'll make sure we get that in as well. John, good to talk to you again. Congratulations on all the success, and we'll talk soon, okay?
Thanks for having me.
All right, John Dwyer, the CEO of formerly Gamelancer Media Corp and now Vertiqal Studios.